It's an exclamation, literally. To be honest, yeah, it's not, that word is not from any language. It's my language. I was freestyling and I came up with it and I thought it sounded great. But it's an exclamation. It's like when you say OMG or when you say, you know what I mean? Like when you say damn or when you say wow or something like that.
Has happened since the last time we talked.
Well, plenty, man.
A shitload of songs have dropped. That was Love and Nwantiti, aka
dropped what, 2020?
I thought it was like 2019.
Or even 19.
So it was like 2019. But that was the remix. The
dropped a year ago, so I think early 2000.
Oh, the actual song? Mid
2020, yeah.
Are you sure? Love and Nwantiti?
Yeah, I think it dropped. The video dropped February 2020, Valentine's Day.
Yeah,
February
so the 14th. Song. I'm talking about when the song dropped.
Probably a few weeks before that, if not around the same time.
It's by Ckay.
We've played it here a long time
ago. Yeah, it's on our playlist. Yeah. It's on our playlist. But this was a remix version, and this is the version that's really taking off now.
A young DJ from Mauritius Island. His name is DJ Yo. He remixed the acoustic version of the song. He put drums on it and uploaded it. It's so crazy because we didn't even know about the release. It was an illegal upload. We found out about it when it got to the top 50 of the global Shazam charts. So my team had to reach out and kind of reclaim the song and everything. And it's so crazy because the day we reclaimed the song, the next day it was number one on Shazam.
Ckay got another wind on his sail. This is huge. It is moving up the charts. It is moving up the American charts even. I think it's entered top 100. It's, the streams are ridiculous. Apparently it gained a newfound notoriety over TikTok.
Different people started making all types of challenges with that song. Some people were using it for memes, some people were using it to dance, some people were using it for makeup, fashion, travel. Like, people were using Love Nwantiti for all sorts of things, people from different cultures. And it literally just went even more viral than the first time. It's crazy to see people from different parts of the world vibing to the song, even if they don't understand the meaning.
Wally?
Yeah, so it was TikTok. Yeah, it was TikTok. Talk and so there was that video of the Kardashians at the Met Gala.
At the Met Gala, yes.
Where somebody dubbed the audio.
The audio on top
but
of it.
The TikTok version and the audio is not the original version.
It's not.
The same thing with Love Nwantiti.
But this the one version, they slowed it down.
They slowed it down
bit.
In this one. They slowed it down
a little bit more.
And then it has the echoey thing. Mm-hmm. It's but the thing is that the DJs are not changing the lyrics or adding the lyrics or whatever. It's just changing the mixing. They're remixing the song as actual remix. So
yeah, this was by DJ Yo. You ever heard of
where
him?
Where I'm getting at is that I think sometimes we have to give all these DJs props, man, because you know, if I was Ckay, and I'm pretty sure maybe he has, I would definitely give this DJ props because the original is fine. I prefer the original.
I like the original too, but I like this one too. Do you know Ckay is now the most biggest streaming artist on Spotify?
Yes,
it's crazy. He has over 20 million
and
over 20 million listeners
and,
monthly.
Thames, you know, Thames was Wiz. It wasn't Wiz. It was Burner for a while.
Yes.
Then Wiz.
Then
came,
Wiz. Then Thames.
Then Thames, because she had the Wiz song and the Drake song.
Yes.
And now it's him.
Yeah.
But obviously, give it a year or two, Burna and Wiz will probably get back to the top just based on the fact that it's monthly listeners. So it averages
It averages
you
out.
Know, but the beauty about it is Ckay has been on my list of who to watch. Mm-hmm. So I don't doubt that. I don't think it's going to go from 20 million to 1 million.
Yeah.
I think Ckay is going to drop songs that are still going to keep people listening. Like, he's not a one-hit wonder, is what I'm saying.
Yeah.
So I still believe.
We've even played another of his songs since then.
It's part of the people I've listed. Yeah. Look, everyone I've listed always does.
So what's Ckay's story?
I don't know his story.
Do you know where he's originally from?
I don't know, actually.
It's so crazy because they probably don't understand what it even means. There's a southeastern Nigerian language called Igbo. It's the tribe I'm from, and it means small love, literally. But it also means, in context, when you see like a couple, like love between a couple, and it like the way it just makes you feel, like the way it just looks good on them, the love looks good on them. It's also called love Nwantiti.
Only reason why I know of him is I think he used to be signed to Chocolate City. I think so. I don't know. I think he used to be signed to Chocolate City. And I remember it was that time. Okay, no, he's an Igbo guy. Chukuka.
Siki. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah. Interesting. Even his album has been getting streamed.
Yeah. But I'm happy for the guy.
He like, ascribes to a new genre, well, to a new subgenre of Afrobeat called, he calls it emo Afrobeat.
Well, I can see. I'll say Love Nwantiti has a foundation in some highlight, but it's just that with me, my approach to it, it's basically guitar music that was created in like the earlier parts of the 20th century, like the 40s, 50s, and they fused jazz with Hawaii. It was like a mixture of Hawaiian jazz and a little bit of Spanish jazz, and they put African rhythms on it, and that became highlight.
So I can see how even Love Nwantiti is about his feelings for a girl, you know, how she makes him feel. Which, remember anytime I started talking about these new genre of artists, that I love it because they're giving us something totally different. And I can see how Joey, I can would call it emo-ish or emo be it does. But I just like the beauty of Afrobeat today is that there's no one more. There's no one sound anymore.
And I think that's part of what
and that's why it's makes growing.
The genre it's have so, essence so much is potential. R&B song.
As it a, really is an R&B song.
That's what makes the genre have so much potential. So there are R&B so many. There's so much market.